Hello, my name is Ilse Smits. I'm the Program Director and Exchange Coordinator of the Master of Chemical Engineering at KU Leuven. During the presentation that I will give here, I will try to give you the answers to the what, how, who, where and why of the Chemical Engineering Master at KU Leuven. And starting with the what, of course, you should be aware of it already. And we turn to Wikipedia because they summarize in a very efficient manner the definition of chemical engineering. It's all about designing large-scale processes and making useful products on the basis of the knowledge that we get from basic sciences like physics and chemistry, and also life science and some mathematics and economics. And we do that all with environmental and safety aspects in the back of our mind. If we have this as a definition of chemical engineering, then we see this applied in a lot of companies, different types of companies. Some of you might be well aware of, like the big ExxonMobil's and BASF and Bayer, etc. of this world. All of them have a basis also in Belgium, in the Antwerp harbor. But also smaller companies or other companies that are, for example, focusing on the production of polyolefins, for example, here for Borealis, are out there. And while some of them might still have the stigma of being a very polluting industry, others, or a lot of them, have already made a lot of efforts to really, really make a transition and also to really change their concept. For example, Borealis here, with all the knowledge that they have of making plastic films, they now are applying this knowledge towards films that can be exploited in photovoltaic cells, so in solar panels, for example. But these are the well-known examples. However, our chemical engineers are also much appreciated in environmental utilities, for example, like Aquafin, who is responsible for the wastewater treatment processes in Belgium, and also in the pharmaceutical industry. The same engineering principles are lying behind the production of, for example, vaccines. Now, also the food industry and the industry for personal care products, they are all happy to welcome you as a graduated chemical engineer. So we have a lot of collaborations also within the department, and you see on the left, those are more the process-oriented companies who more make the bulk chemicals, which are then the basis, the building blocks for other products. While here at the right, you have more the product-oriented industries where you have a more high added value product that's immediately produced by them. So if you see this, we have a process oriented towards a product-oriented industry field. And of course, we want to prepare our chemical engineers to be a valuable asset in these industries. So how did we combine all this in our Chemical Engineering Master Program in Leuven? Now, first of all, I want to really have this disclaimer here. We are not a research-based master, but we provide a course-based master. And so the people that come into our masters and did already a bachelor at the KU Leuven in Belgium, they have this bachelor diploma, but it's not their end diploma. So all of them will pursue a master because only in the end, after 5 years, in that case, 3+2, they will have really a diploma that is valuable for our industry. So we have a course-based master. And as you will see here, a lot of them, 69 out of the 120 credits, are core courses. Courses that are taken up by all of our chemical engineering students. So you have different focuses of these courses, but it's all the same for everyone. And this is also inspired by our Industrial Advisory Board, who really wants us to prepare you with a very thorough and broad basis. And they say to us, they tell us, like, okay, we will make specialists out of them once they have entered our companies. So a lot of core courses, which come back here in the green block. And then in the second master year, you complement these core courses with some option courses. We have three blocks, potential option courses, and those are devoted to bio and chemical reactor engineering, product engineering, or environmental engineering, or I can call also this the sustainable system engineering. which encompass each time 12 credits. I will come back to that in a minute. Then you have your master thesis also in the last master year of 24 credits. And in the end also some, you can also fill up then the rest of the 120 credits with some electives, general broadening electives, or some technical electives that you can choose in your program. Going back to these options, we didn't take them out of the blue. No, they are really embedded, or they are really provided by our three research divisions in the department, namely the CREAS division, which is biochemical reactor engineering and safety, all about bioreactors, in fact, so we take the bio route here. SMART, soft matter and rheology technology, that's for the product design, that's the keyword there. And then the process division, that's the processes for sustainable systems. Their process intensification is the buzz and keyword, miniaturization, efficient use of energy to, in fact, avoid environmental problems and issues at the end of the process, instead of just solving some water, air or soil pollution problems. So those are lying at the basis of the three options, one of the three options you can choose. If you want to also have another distinction between our master and, for example, the American system, then it's also in the evaluation process, the assessment that we do for our students to really make them see whether they failed or passed the courses. We have, in fact, very few evaluation moments during the semester. So no quizzes, a very, very limited amount of graded exercise sessions, some graded presentations that you have to give, but that's all quite limited. So the focus point of the evaluation of the assessment is really during the exam periods, either in January after the first semester, either in June after the second semester. And so these examination periods are then really evaluating your knowledge and skills that you gather throughout the semester. And most often, of course, now we are in a different situation with Corona, but most often the courses are evaluated during an oral exam. So you prepare it in a written way, but you defend orally your exam. If you look at the people that you will encounter that will try to guide you along the path towards becoming a chemical engineer, you will see here that divided over the three divisions, as I introduced already, you have a lot of young people. I call myself also still young. But also a nice spread of nationalities and of the gender. So we are very proud to have a strong force of professors of faculty who will guide you along the way, either based in Leuven or in Kortrijk, for example, but that's a detail. Where are we sitting? Where are we doing all this research and a part of our education? Well, we have a brand new building, a Chemtech and Nano Center building, brand new. Well, it's 5 to 6 years old, which is very recent. And in this big building, we have more than 500 researchers. Not only our chemical engineering colleagues are there, but also the colleagues from the chemistry department and from a big division of the bioscience engineering faculty, namely the surface chemistry and catalysis group, are also housed in these buildings, which means that we have a lot of expertise, a lot of disciplines, and we can really, really boost multidisciplinarity and the use of each other's equipment, which is really enriching and is turning out to be really a win-win situation for all of us. So here you see a view on our labs. And so the Nano Center is then, as we call it, the black box, but it's a box that cannot vibrate. So it's a vibration-free area in which nanoparticles can be made in a very accurate and efficient way. And our colleagues of the SMART division, soft matter and rheology technology, they are sitting literally on the bridge between these two buildings. So chemical engineering, chemical technology, chemistry, and nanoscience. For our didactics, we have the big aulas on the campus where we reside, but also a brand new building, the Quadrivium, in which we have the biggest aula of 600 students, but also new spaces, new lab spaces for our didactics for towards the master's and the bachelor students, of which you see a view here. So also brand new. This year, we started to use these new spaces. Okay, finally, international character with the international spirit that we try to boost is very important. So we try to send our students out for our Belgian students then. And of course, we welcome you as international students in our master. If I take a rough number, which is rather consistent over the last years, then we have 60 students in our master, of which 40 come from our own bachelor at the KU Leuven, so the Belgian students, 10, about 10, between 3 and 10 international students, degree-seeking students, a lot of Erasmus students who come for one semester or 1 year, for example, still, and those are not counted within these 60, but also about 10 students who join us from the Master in Chemical Engineering Technology, also a Belgian master there. We do this master in English. We provide it in English because then we can, of course, encourage this international character. And also, again, our industry is very happy with that because you will end up in a very international environment once you start working in industry. And we have nice exchange programs. But to be honest, that is, I encourage that a bit more for our local students to, for them to also for them have an international environment or experience while you already are coming to Belgium to have an international experience. But we can discuss that later if you want. Then I want to summarize our chemical engineering master. What are the assets? Perhaps something that is not really mentioned here on the slide, but we deviate really from the classical chemical engineering, which would be still focused perhaps on petroleum-based research and education. So in our case, it's the bio route. We have product focus, product design focus, and this process intensification as real focus points. We have a strong international focus. We are exploiting state-of-the-art new research infrastructure and also new educational lab infrastructures. And we have a strong link with the important chemical industry. Within our master, it is visualized, it's apparent through a lot of interactions with our international and industrial advisory board. But also we have people from industry who provide guest lectures, who are faculty members, and who really teach from their own professional experience. We also organize company visits, etc. Of course, a bit less in Corona times, but that's normally in the program. So, final point is then employability. And yes, there are really still ample job opportunities, definitely in Belgium, because the pharmaceutical and the chemical sector, they have kept on hiring new people, even during Corona crisis. But I have to be honest here, often Dutch is still a requirement also in an international company. So if you really want to stick and stay in Belgium after your studies, do some effort already to try to learn also the Dutch language, because that will be an asset for you if you apply for a job in a Belgian company or a Belgian branch of an international company. But so also the starting salaries are very appealing in comparison with other sectors. But of course, that should not be the only reason why you choose for this master and for this discipline to study. Voilà. I hope that I have convinced you to proceed with a chemical engineering and education, hopefully at KU Leuven. And if there are still some more content-wise or practical questions, you can always mail me ilse.smets@kuleuven.be. Have a nice day. Bye.